Sophia was the most fascinating woman I've ever known. She was a study in opposites. Strong, self-contained, and very vulnerable. Sophisticated, and always natural. Complex, and sometimes she was utterly childlike. She had a vast and wonderful curiosity about the world. She was so lovely that sometimes I ached when I looked at her. She was eminently, totally, and exquisitely lovable. And you're exactly like her.
You must have loved her very much. Did my father know? Did he know that you knew her? You must have been destroyed when she died. Are you all right?
I'd like... Are you doing... Do you have something to do this afternoon?
I don't know. Why?
I'd like you to come and see something with me. Something that I think will be important to you.
What is it?
It's something that... Well, I can't show it to you here. You'll have to come with me to see it. It's about your mother.
My mother?
Mm-hmm.
I really don't think that I could make the time this afternoon. I don't really think it's a good idea.
It's not far. I'm not asking you to go to the end of the earth.
Well, I don't understand why you can't just tell me what it is.
I guess you're gonna have to trust me. Take it as an act of faith. Are you capable of making an act of faith?
It seems like more of an act of folly.
How about it?
All right, I'll take my chances.
How'd you ever get so suspicious of people?
Well, I trust people, Mr. Lockridge. I just don't trust you.
You can trust me. You can trust me more than anyone on earth. Come on.
Dr. Ramirez, I'm a lawyer, and I can tell you these things happen all the time. It's no one's fault.
I can't help you. I had a dreadful experience with Santana Andrade.
What did you say?
Santana Andrade, the natural mother. She appeared down here one day out of the blue and gave me a terrible time. Sissy knows all about it. I never want to see her again. So you'll have to take care of this matter yourself. I'm sorry. I often wondered, though, if she did find out. Do you know?
What?
Did Santana ever find out where her child was?
No, she didn't.
Well, I'm glad to hear it. She certainly made things very difficult for me while she was here.
All right. Thank you for your help.
It was a pleasure talking to you, Mr. Capwell.
Thank you, Doctor. Goodbye.
You're all finished?
Yeah.
Did you find out what you wanted to know?
Yeah.
Great. So tell me, what do you think of my new outfit? Is it becoming on me? Come on, give me more of an answer than a yes or a no. Is it the kind of thing that drives a man to drink?
I'm sorry, do you mind?
No, not at all. Not as long as you tell me whether or not you like it. Come on, I just bought it. I'll burn it if you hate it.
It's fine.
Oh, Mason, it has to be better than fine. How about ravishing or breathtaking or something?
No, I'm sorry. I like it very much. It's very attractive.
Very attractive. Well, I guess I'm going to have to settle for that if that's going to be the best answer I'm going to get. Are you all right?
Yeah, I'm fine.
You don't seem fine to me, Mason. Come on, is it that phone call? Is that what's disturbing you?
Do you really want to know? Well, it has to do with nothing at all. At least nothing important.
Mason, the way you're looking at me, you make me believe that call was about me.
No.
Well, something is very wrong. What's happened now? Is it more bad news?
Santana Andrade, the natural mother. Sissy knows all about it.
If this is boring you, I told you I had to do this and you said you didn't mind waiting.
I'm waiting. Go ahead. Finish.
Thank you.
Well, what's the matter now?
It's you. You are making me very nervous.
What are you nervous about?
I'm nervous because you're staring at me.
I'm only staring at you because you're nervous.
All right, I'm nervous. Now, will you please stop staring at me?
I'm not staring at you. I'm looking at you.
No, what you are doing is staring at me. A long, hard, fixed gaze is not the same as a glance.
Look, are you looking for a job or are you doing crossword puzzles?
What I am doing now is wasting my time. Okay, this is not something that two people can do, so why don't I just put this aside? I'll make my calls later, and you and I can go out to lunch or something.
No, listen, that's not the way to get a job. Now, listen, by the time you get around to calling someone, they may have gotten the job. Here, sit down. Make the calls, because I know it's important.
It is important. You know I've got to get a job right away.
Right.
There are only a couple of things I want to check out, and you're right, I shouldn't let them slide, so I'll just call one of them, okay?
Fine.
Okay.
Call as many as you like.
Will you please stop pacing? Now, sit over here. Relax.
Okay.
Read a book.
All right. I'll try.
Sit down. Would you believe it? There's nobody there. I guess they're out to lunch. It's probably what people do at lunchtime. They go out to lunch.
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay, I'm really nervous. But you would be if you were me, too.
I believe it.
All right, fine. I'll come clean. You win. I know you probably guessed it already. I don't know how long I thought I could fool you. You probably noticed it the minute you came in, and you've just been waiting for me to admit it. Well, fine. I admit it. I'm pregnant. Now, are you satisfied? No, you please stop staring at me.
I decided, and Mason agreed, that it would be best for him to find another place to live.
Well, you and Mason must have a very big problem.
Well, a problem implies a solution. And in the situation with Mason, there is no solution.
Uncle Cece, come look!
What is it, partner?
Your desk, it's a mess!
My desk?
Yes, come see!
Well, come on, show me.
See?
Yes, you're right. It is quite a mess. Mason. Oh, I know you didn't, Brandon. That's all right. I'll take care of everything. I don't want you to worry. Gina?
Yeah, let's let Uncle Cece straighten up here and not bother him. Come on, honey.
How'd it get like that?
I don't know.
He's seen my will. He knows it all. What he's going to try to do next.
Mason, are you getting drunk in the middle of the day?
I couldn't get drunk now if I wanted to.
Listen, I know something's bothering you, but I have a confession to make to you. It's not going to be easy, so I'll need your attention.
Go ahead, I'm listening.
It has to do with Cece and me.
What about you and Cece?
Well, somewhere in the back of my mind, I have always wanted your father. I even had delusions that he wanted me to. I mean, I actually thought he did. I let myself dream that we could actually be together on a more permanent basis. It's incredible. Even in the last few weeks, after everything that's happened, I still thought that we had a chance.
Even though you and I were seeing each other.
Mason, I'm sorry. I didn't realize what a fool I've been and how unfair I've been to you. You know, it's only been in the last few days that I've come to my senses.
All this time, it was my father that you wanted, and not me. I've managed to make a colossal fool out of myself, haven't I?
No, you haven't. I wanted to be honest with you. I wanted you to understand exactly what's been keeping us from being close. Why? I haven't been able to let you in. I haven't been able to care about you romantically because I still had thoughts of Cece.
And now?
And now? It doesn't exist anymore. I've gotten him completely out of my system. Once and for all.
You're telling me you've gotten over my father?
Listen, I was blind. I couldn't see anyone. And now I want to get to know you better.
Santana, I've never held back anything from you.
It wasn't your doing. I just couldn't see. But now we have to start over. I've known from the very beginning, when we were growing up, that you're a fighter. You and Channing, you and your father, I know you didn't get along with them. But I also know what a wonderful, gentle soul you have. To me, you're a peaceful man and you're a hero.
I'm not sure I'm cut out of the heroic mold.
Maybe you just can't help yourself. Look, you saved my life, mine and Brandon's, and I'll never forget that. To me, you are wonderful and you're a hero.
Now has nothing at all to offer you.
Do you think I care that you've been disinherited? Let me tell you something. If they stripped you of everything and sent you into exile, it wouldn't mean anything to me. I care a lot more about you now than I did when you were the heir apparent to all of Cece's millions.
Do you really mean that?
Yes, I do.
I can't know how much that means to me.
Mason, do you have such a low opinion of yourself that you think you're only worth the amount of money you have in the bank?
I don't know. Santana, are you telling me how you feel?
Yes, I am.
I think you know how much I care about you.
I think so.
I don't just care about you. I love you. You know that.
Mason.
Listen. Before we go any further, there's something I have to tell you. A confession of my own. It's driving me crazy. I have to talk to you about it.
Please tell me. You can count on me.
I know you have a child. And I know that child is Brandon DeMott.
Aren't you going to say anything? Anything at all?
Pregnant.
You're probably shocked and a whole lot of other things. I don't know what right you have to be shocked, but you probably are. Modern men are so old-fashioned.
I didn't say I was shocked.
No, but you didn't say what you were thinking either. Well, I guess that's not so hard to guess. Probably thinking I'm a real idiot. I'm an idiot for getting pregnant in this day and age. You're probably assuming that I love the guy. Well, you're right. I did, or at least I thought I did. Isn't that good enough? Then you're probably wondering whether or not I intend to keep the baby. Or whether or not I even intend to have it at all. I don't know if that is your question. I don't know that at all. Rick, please. Please tell me what you're thinking.
Does the father know?
No. No, he doesn't.
I see. Well, are you planning to tell him?
Tell him about the baby.
That's what we're talking about, isn't it? Are you having trouble keeping track?
No.
Don't you think he kind of has a right to know?
Yes, it would be the honorable thing to do, wouldn't it? Trouble is, I have been wanting to tell him. He has every right to know. I've just been kind of dreading it.
Why?
Because he might not be terribly sympathetic about it. If he were a more sensitive, gentler person, something like this could have even brought us closer together.
Is that what you're hoping for, that he'll take you back?
I don't know what I'm hoping for. I thought I'd stopped hoping for anything. I guess I haven't. I guess I could call and tell him.
Send him a wire.
Please don't be sarcastic.
Well, come on, a call, phone call.
Well, then I wouldn't do that, I guess. I don't know what. I keep thinking if I give myself enough time, I'll come up with the right idea.
I'm not pushing you.
I guess what I could do is, I could fly to San Francisco. Yes, I guess that's what I'll do. I want to get this over with, and it's a quick trip. I guess I could go up there and back in a day.
When did you plan to go?
I don't know. Today. Now. Yes.
Terrific. Look, I don't think that's such a hot idea either.
What do you suggest I do? Send him a message by village drum?
I just think a trip like that would be very tiring for you, that's all. I think you need to take care of yourself.
Don't be silly. No, I'm not ready for confinement yet. I think I'll call the airlines now and make a reservation.
Unless you think you're going to change your mind.
Yes, can I have the number for California Central Airlines reservations, please? Yes.
Hey, listen, you know, I got an idea.
Thank you. What?
How about if I go along with you?
To San Francisco?
Right.
Absolutely not. It's out of the question. Yes, I'd like to make a reservation to San Francisco. One person round trip today, please. Yes, I'll wait.
Cece, what happened? Do you know who did this?
Oh, yes. Mason.
Well, that's terrible.
He's completely out of control.
Why would he do something like this? Cece, I had no idea that Mason was so involved in Brandon's adoption. You never told me.
What did Mason say to you about it?
Well, just that he knew about the situation in Acapulco and the arrangements made with Dr. Ramirez, everything.
He told you all of that?
Well, yes, but there's no harm in that, is there?
No, of course not.
Cece, I know this is not my business, but I do care about you. I don't like seeing you like this.
I appreciate your concern.
I'm always concerned about you. You know that. Well, I better check with Rosa about lunch, and Brandon must be starving.
Mason has been pumping her to find out more about Brandon. He must hate Brandon now that Brandon is going to inherit his share. Mason is a dangerous man. He's a killer. He could hurt Brandon. He could.
Who told you about Brandon? How did you hear about that?
You had a baby in Acapulco. You gave it up for adoption. The entire transaction was arranged by my father. What happened, Santana? You had an accident, you ran to your parents, they ran to Cece, and Cece fixed everything the way he loves to do.
Something like that.
What I can't understand is why you gave the baby up for adoption. Why you didn't want it. I thought you loved children.
I do.
And yet you could turn it over to my father to give it away. You couldn't have wanted it very much.
Mason, I was very young. I didn't realize what
Why put yourself through all that pain? The pain of having it. Why not just have an abortion?
I don't believe in abortion.
What about the father? What did he believe in? Who was he, anyway?
It doesn't matter who the father was. Look, none of that matters now. How can you ask me questions like this? What gives you the right?
What was it, Santana? Casual roll in the hay? One-night stand? You got burned and the woman always pays, right?
That's a vicious thing to say.
Well, I'm sorry. I'm a little angry right now. Somehow it makes it worse that it was only a casual affair.
Mason, I can't change the past.
You know, I remember it seemed... Seems strange to me back then that you were sent away to Acapulco for the summer to take care of the house. You left one day without any word of farewell or goodbye. I had no idea it was for that.
You weren't supposed to.
No, of course not. You were spirited away in the dead of night. Santana, I'm surprised at some of the things I'm learning about you. You're very different from what I thought you were.
Why? Because I'm human? Are the women that men love supposed to be virgins?
No, I don't expect virginity. A little honesty would be nice, though. Tell me, Santana, what other dark secrets do you have? What else don't I know?
Nothing.
I don't believe that.
Well, then don't.
If there is anything else, I wish you'd tell me now. I don't like learning secrets about people that I'm in love with. I don't want to find out other worse things later on. So if there's anything else, Santana, you better tell me now.
What are you doing here?
This is where I come when I want to get away from you, Paul. No one else has access to this room, not even Augusta.
Where'd you get the keys?
Oh, the museum and I made an arrangement. They don't use it very often, and then just for research. Sometimes I come here just to read, write, and do other things.
Oh, I see.
It's kind of a sanctuary for me sometimes. Sit down, make yourself comfortable.
I still don't know what it is you want to show me.
This.
A tape of what?
It's something that was done a long time ago. I'm sorry, I don't have any popcorn to offer you. We're using this room.
Sorry, sir, just making the rounds.
We're having a private meeting in here. We don't wish to be disturbed.
Sorry, sir.
Mason, I can't change the past, so there's no point in talking about it anymore. Brandon belongs to Gina, and there's nothing I can do about it. He'll soon belong to Cece. He's not a part of my life anymore.
And you're content with that?
No, but I can't do anything about it.
This has all been very painful for you, hasn't it?
I gave Brandon up for adoption because I had to. And after I did, I realized what a terrible mistake I'd made. And I tried to find out what happened to him. I just wanted to see him. Just to see what he looked like. But of course, your father wouldn't tell me anything. He said I'd made an agreement, and I had to stick to it.
Yeah, my father's a great one for sticking to agreements as long as it suits him. Do you know why he was so insistent about putting the child up for adoption?
I suppose because of my parents. So that they wouldn't have the stigma of their wayward daughter. Or maybe it was to please Stockman Demont. I mean, they were very close, and he knew that Gina couldn't bear him children. Anyway, after your father wouldn't tell me anything, I went to Acapulco to try and find out what I could from Dr. Ramirez. But Dr. Ramirez wouldn't tell me anything. Your father did such a good job on him. So I came home, frustrated and angry.
I can imagine. How did you find out?
Because of Gina. When Gina came here with Brandon, I put the pieces together myself. And they all seemed to fit.
I remember you asking me questions about Brandon. His birthday. You had suspicions early on, didn't you?
Yes.
Santana, why didn't you come to me? Why did you hide all this from me?
Mason, I couldn't tell anybody about this. I couldn't come to you. What would you have done anyway?
I might have been able to help you. That's why my father wanted to keep you away from Gina and Brandon. He was afraid that you might tell one of them the truth. Or worse, that you might try to get Brandon back. My Lord, no wonder you and my father haven't been getting along. Wait a minute, there's something that doesn't fit.
What do you mean?
You and my father were getting together before you knew who Brandon was. I remember how nice you were being to him. I remember it clearly because I hated seeing it. But now I understand that.
You understand what?
Well, you were doing all that so that you could find out what he had done with your baby. That's why you were being nice to him. You were only using him.
It doesn't sound very nice the way you put it.
You never really cared for Cece at all, did you?
Mason, I can't say that. Yes, I did. I learned to.
How could you have after what he did with your child? And then I can't believe how much you must have suffered. I've seen you with Brandon, here and in Nice. I know how much you love him.
I would have given my life for him.
Santana, I wanted to be the father of your children. I wanted you to love me and bear me sons. That could still happen. I do still love you, want you. It can. You said yourself, we're only human. We all make mistakes. We shouldn't be punished for them all our lives.
I'm so confused.
It's all right. You.
It's a collection of pictures of her that I put together over the years. Put on this tape. It's kind of a love letter to Sophia. She's very beautiful, isn't she?
Yes, she is.
That trembles on the brink. This next one is a kind of an audition scene. It was an informal interview with a director in Hollywood where she wanted to see
how
she
photographed. Tell us a little bit about yourself.
You want me to bare my soul to you pirates, don't you? Go ahead, ask me anything you want.
Come on, we're not that bad.
Sure you are. You can ask me what I like and what I want to do, and if or not I wear anything to bed.
No.
I promise you I'll just tell you what I would tell my own mother. Okay, I love music, and I love art, and I love to sail, and I love to ski. Oh, and of course I love being an actress, so I wouldn't be here, would I?
Okay, now how about the unexpurgated version?
All right. Well, I like to sing at the top of my lungs, and I have a terrible voice. I can't carry a tune. And I'm vain. I am. And I'm ambitious. And I am totally, always self-assured. Except I just cry at the drop of a hat and feel vulnerable all the time.
Good. Now, the scene you're going to be playing, Sophia, it's a love scene. Do you think of yourself as sexy?
I can make any man feel like a real man.
Okay.
Now, let me tell you about the children I want to have. I want to have a dozen children, and they are going to be beautiful and smart and sassy, and I'm going to be the best mother in the world, and do you know why? Because I know how to love, and that's what I'm going to teach my children. I'm going to teach them how to love and how to be loved.
Fine. Thank you, Sophia. Thank you very much.
If she could see her children now, she'd be very proud.
I never knew her, really. Oh, I wish I had.
Take a card, lady?
What? Brick!
Hi! Take one.
No, stop it. If you've come to see me off, they don't allow that on airplanes.
I'm going with you.
No, you're not.
I recommend the Three of Hearts.
Don't you ever take no for an answer.
Yes, but not this time. There's no way you are going to go back into the ring with a guy like that without having me around. I saw what he did to you before. That's why I'm coming.
You don't think I can take care of myself, do you?
You got it.
Neither do I. I'm very glad you've come. But you shouldn't have.
Why not?
Because it's not your problem. I got myself into this mess, and I should be forced to get myself out. It's good for building my character, I think.
Well, what's more likely is that you'll probably just get in deeper. He'll probably give you a nice smile, and you'll start darning his socks and splitting the rent with him.
Oh, you think I'm a real pushover, don't you?
Pregnant women tend to be a little vulnerable.
How did you read that in a Chinese fortune cookie or something?
Maybe. I suppose you, always wanted to have this kid.
Not in the first hour that I met him, but He said he wanted children. I thought that's what he said.
Terrific. That explains that. You were dumb enough to get pregnant.
I wasn't trying to trap him. I was trying to please him. We talked about the joys of having children, and I wanted to be the one that had them with him. That's at least what I thought he said. I'm hoping now that he really did mean it.
I guess that's what we're on our way to find out. Maybe when he hears that you're pregnant, he'll want to change his mind. Get back with you. Let's say he does. What will you do?
I don't know.
Don't you think you'd better know? In about an hour, you're going to run into him in the restaurant. He'll be there. The father of your baby.
I don't have any answers, but please. I don't know. I don't know what I'm going to do.
This isn't right.
What?
This isn't right. I should have shared this moment with my father, not my mother's lover. It's supposed to be her daughter and the man she was truly in love with that should be experiencing this. It's not right for me to be here, to be seeing old films of my mother with someone who sneaked around and chased me the way you did.
I'm sorry you feel that way about it.
I want that tape.
What? Why?
I want to give it to my father.
Oh. How would you explain where you got it?
I don't know. I'll think of something, but I really don't want you to have it.
It really hurts me to think that you feel that strongly about it. But if you do...
Why not?
I can't just hand these memories to Cece Capwell. I'm the one who kept Sophia's memory alive all these years. I'm the one who hasn't forgotten.
You think my father has?
He hasn't remembered the way I have.
You're wrong. Who appointed you Keeper of the Flame anyway? Look at me! The way you preserved my mother has caused a lot of problems for a lot of people. And I happen to know that my father loved my mother much more than you ever could have. Much more.
Cece Capwell may have married her. She may have had his children. But he never really understood her. This woman that we've just seen on this tape, if there were 100 Cece Capwells, he would never, ever understand or have loved her the way I did. I'm sorry. I'm sorry. Please, wait. Wait, Eva. I'm sorry. I have something for you.
I don't want any more of your gifts.
All right, this is for your father, not for you. It's kind of an invitation, really. Yeah, this is a contract, a copy of the contract for a major network to come and televise the raising and the opening of the artworks and the chest from the Amanda Lockridge.
I don't understand you. I really don't. If you really care for my mother, you would not try to malign my family this way.
Sophia wasn't a Capwell, at least not by blood. And as for that, I could never do to your father what he's already done to me.
And that's supposed to make it right. Is it? An eye for an eye. It just keeps going on, and it just gets worse. It's childish, and it's wrong, and it hurts so many people. Why can't someone just say, no, it's over, we're finished. Why? Don't touch me! And don't ever talk to me like this again. Never.
How come you went to work in San Francisco in the first place?
That's easy. I wanted to see if I could make it on my own. All that I did find out was that I was terrific at messing things up on my own.
Come on.
No, I'm a specialist at lousing things up. What's wrong with me? I hate people that sound like I do.
I don't. Amy, you're not alone. You've got friends. I wish you could remember that.
What I will remember is how very nice you've been to me. You've taken a lousy situation and made it your own, and I'm very grateful. However, I don't think it's a good idea for you to come to dinner with me tonight.
What do I do? Sit in the park and see if the pigeon will feed me?
If he walks into the restaurant and sees you sitting with me, he is really bound to get the wrong idea.
Well, I think he's got a head full of wrong ideas already. Besides, I'm not here taking this trip at my own expense, I might add, to have missed the main event.
This is not meant to be a public spectacle, you know. This is not just fun and games. I still have some feelings for this guy who really happens to be the father of my unborn child. I wouldn't have flown all this way if I didn't still have some feelings for him, if I didn't want to see him. So please, don't treat this as a lark, okay?
I'm sorry, I didn't mean it to sound the way I did.
I'm just going into this with a lot of expectations, or at least some expectations.
Fine. But you're not going into it alone. Period.
You talked to Mason and told him that Brandon was Santana's son? I don't believe it. How could you have been so careless?
Mr. Campbell, I did have to tell him. He already knew.
He didn't know anything at all. He tricked you, that's all. You were stupid, Ramirez. Stupid.
I tell you, he knew.
You want to think that he knew, because you don't want to admit how easy it was for him to manipulate you. But I can tell you, Mason had no knowledge of this whatsoever. I have been careful to see that no one knew anything about it, which is more than I can say for you. And I think it would do well for you to remember, Dr. Ramirez, that my continued financial support was dependent on your keeping your mouth shut about this to anyone, including my son.
Hello?
Santana, this is Cece. Is Mason there?
Yes, Cece. He is.
May I speak with him? I've been trying to reach him all over town.
Hold on a minute, okay? He wants to talk to you.
No, I don't want to talk to him.
Mason, come on, please.
I don't know why you're calling me. I don't think we have anything at all to say to one another.
You're mistaken. I have something very definite to say to you.
Then go ahead. But I'd appreciate it if you'd make it quick.
I found out a little while ago that you were in touch with Dr. Ramirez in Acapulco. You have been, haven't you?
That's right, I have.
I talked to him, found out the whole ugly story. I know the truth now about Santana, her baby, and the part you played in all of it.
And I know the very truth about the kind of man you are. Kind of violent, dangerous man you are.
Who pulled the gun on who, Dad? Is that all you have to talk to me about?
No, it isn't. I'm warning you, Mason. If you will lay a hand on Santana
or Brandon, I'll...
You'll what?
I'm sorry. I'm so sorry about all of this.
Santana, do you care anything at all for me?
How can you ask me that? Of course.
Don't say it to be polite. I want to hear the truth.
It is the truth.
I need to know how much. I have to know how much you care.
Mason, I don't know how to measure my feelings. I do care about you.
I hope that's true. I hope you care about me half as much as I care about you. I've fantasized about being with you for over a decade now. But ever since we got back from Nice, it's been almost unbearable. I don't think I can wait anymore. If you give me the chance, I'll make you happy in ways you never even thought of before. I'm gonna drive the rest of the world out of your head, make you forget every other man you've ever known. Santana, I have to have you.
See, I'm not gonna give this to you.
Give it to me.
for. It has no conceivable value for you. None at all. It's not even expensive.
Just stop arguing with me and hand it over.
Wait a minute. You are mistaken about the value of what's in this. Here, just let me show it to you. Look, there's no money, no drugs, nothing of any value.
Give it to me.
Just a videotape, you said. It's a collection of things about someone I knew once. Would mean nothing to you.
Give it to me now.
Waited for this long, long time.
Mason.
Don't say no, Santana.
Mason, it's not me that you want as much as you want someone to be with.
Oh, it is you, Santana. It's not just anyone. I love you. I want you to feel about me the same way I feel about you.
Mason, I don't know if I can feel the same way about you.
You will. Never felt about anyone the way I feel about you. You know that.
Yes.
Won't be sorry, Santana. I'm going to be the best lover you ever had. Much better than Channing ever was.
What did you just say?
I said I'm going to be a much better lover than Channing ever dreamed of being.
Where did you ever hear this?
No more talking. I said I was going to make you forget Channing completely, and I meant it. I'm gonna push him right out of your mind.